community activist Julia Mejia has made history in Boston by becoming the first Latina immigrant elected into the city council. The election follows a contested November race and recount that wrapped up just last week when city officials announced that after 3 days of hand counting, Mejia won over candidate Alejandra St. Guillen by one vote. And Councilor-Elect Julia Mejia joins us now. Thank you so much for taking the time to visit us here at CBSN Boston. Following the recount, you came out and said this is a perfect example that every vote matters.
Yeah.
Did you think it was going to be this close?
No, not this close. But throughout our entire campaign, we had been in our community telling people, you have to go out and vote. This is really important. But I think that it's such a blessing in disguise because now we have an opportunity to use this as a case study to show how much your vote matters, and that it was just one is like, I'm beside myself.
And you mobilized a lot of people who hadn't even voted before.
Yeah, no, we were in laundromats and nail salons, you know, barbecues, baby showers. We took every single opportunity that we had to really engage the least likely in helping them understand the importance of being engaged in the electoral process. So I think that in itself, whether or not we would have won, I felt like we were really intentional about who we were trying to organize and mobilize. So we had a really strong showing in low-income communities, and I think that really speaks volumes to the work that we did.
Your election made history, but also you're now part of the most diverse council with a female and a minority majority.
I know. It's perfect, right? I mean, what better way to go inside City Hall already looking at people who are really looking at bringing the city forward and working with folks who are progressive. Mm-hmm. So being the first Latina is really exciting. You know, I'm an Afro-Latina, so I feel the sense of really representing a large base of people in the city of Boston. So I'm looking forward to joining them.
You'll be sworn in next month.
Yep.
What are the issues that people are coming to you and saying this needs to be heard at a city level, at a government level?
I'm going to be sworn in on January the 6th, which is Three Kings Day, which is a big deal for me. It's such a blessing that I'm going to be serving my community. That's my gift. So I'm really emotional about that. But in terms of what are the issues that I'm going to be focusing on the campaign trail, what I heard is that people did not feel heard in the city of Boston. I really want to create the infrastructure for a community-centered approach to policy and decision making, specifically around housing. I think that oftentimes we're reacting to things that are being done to us, and I really want to build the infrastructure and focusing on issues around housing and education. You know, education was my pathway out of poverty. I was the first in my family to graduate high school, so making sure that we have the resources in our public schools to support our most vulnerable learners are the things that I'm going to be tackling. And socioeconomic status, I mean, I grew up in a life of poverty, so my main objective is making sure that everything that I do is looking at how we're going to get people in and out, you know, out of poverty. Mm-hmm.
We don't have much time left, but I do want to also note that you're getting sworn in on a presidential election year. Have you thought about it all? Which candidate you could be supporting?
Yeah, well, you know, it's so funny because I was so focused on my race. You know, I was working full-time and running the campaign at the same time. So I hadn't had the privilege of really following the race. So I haven't made up my mind, but what I do find interesting and I'm really sad to see is that there are not a lot of candidates of color who are participating in the debates, and I think that speaks volumes to representation, and so I'm hoping that things can turn around.
Councilor-elect Julia Mejia, thank you very much.
Thank you.